Now the headmaster Figg.
Thank you. And bow two, begin our students. Begin with the turn. It's okay.
Sorry.
It's all right. I'll answer to the various times. Let's do some deep breath and relaxation. Place one hand over the other. Allow your eyes to close. Press gently with the hands. And if the arms or shoulders become tense, relax them. Feel the weight of the arms and shoulders helping you press in. Breathe in through the nose. Breathe out through the nose as well. Breathe in deeply. Breathe out slowly. Be relaxed. And as you breathe, let the breath be long, deep, small, and smooth. And I'll explain. Continue to breathe. Let the breath be long in duration, so both inhale and exhale take what seems like maybe a long time. Let the breath be deep physically within the body, so feel it low in the abdomen as opposed to up in the chest. Don't force it. Let the breath be small in how much air you take in or let out at a time, like drinking from a small straw. And let the breath be smooth. So even inhale, nothing sudden about it. Smooth inhale, maybe a little pause, full lungs. Smooth exhale, maybe a little pause with empty lungs. Next time you breathe out, release, lower the hands, open the eyes. Right, let's begin the first posture, embracing horse. Separate the feet to a shoulder width apart. Turn the toes in, outside edges of the feet parallel. Bend the knees, sit back, tuck the pelvis, lean forward, circle the arms. Relax again through the neck and shoulders. And relax your gaze so it's like sleepy eyes looking between the hands. You may notice when you relax your gaze that you actually can see more around you. she requires two things that might seem contradictory at first. Careful attention to the alignment, the sensations in the body, at the same time as physical relaxation. So if you're very paying close attention but then getting tense from that, it kind of works against you. But if, or if you're so relaxed you don't notice, well, that's maybe a good way to be anyway, but it wouldn't help your Tai Chi so much. See if you can hold both those things, both the attention to detail and feel in the body, but also as relaxed as you can be in any part you can notice. Probably longer than I said, so go ahead and release, straighten the legs, lower the hands, circle the arms up, breathe in, push palms down, breathe out. All right, let's bring the feet a little closer together, posture two, ride the wild horse. Reset any tension that may have come into the system of the body and the mind. Begin, breathe in. Finish breathing in. Begin to breathe out. Bend, slowly bend the legs. Carefully, just putting a little more bend in the legs, keeping the weight in the heels and outside edges, mostly keeping the feet from moving. Inhale and push. Again, kind of a little bit at a time, coming up smoothly. Exhale. And repeat, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Push with the feet. Upper body upright, relax. Exhale. Okay, small distance, toes. When I say the toes, it's really kind of like the inside of the foot touches. The heel might be a little apart. Yeah. Inhale, allow the feet to remain relaxed. Feel the body extended up from the relaxed feet evenly. Exhale, sink. Feel a little bit of knees out, but remember it's not big, just so they don't press together. Same feeling in the feet. Inhale, come up. Exhale, come down. And again in a small position, breathe in. out, keep the feet from moving, keep the pelvis tucked, especially as you go forward and down. Inhale up. Exhale, slowly down, very good. Out to your large distance, back to your shoulder width. Pardon me. Inhale. Let the shoulders kind of roll, stay relaxed. Neck relaxed, keep the chin a little tucked. Exhale, keep the chin a little tucked, keep the pelvis tucked. Pushing in the feet, feel that active push through the legs. Exhale. Last one. Connect your breath to your movement, make them inseparable. Exhale. In and up. Exhale. And release. Nice. Number three, playing guitar. Turn the left toes out at 60 degrees. Shift your weight into the left leg and circle the arms. Set the right heel forward. Sit back 90% of the weight in the back leg. Keep the left knee out. We say chest concave. Chest concave. So it's part of the kind of like body rounded. But allow the concavity of the chest to be part of your line. Breathe deeply. Playing guitar on the other side, turn the right toes out, shift the weight to the right leg, set the left heel forward, circle the arms, right hand by left elbow, sit back again, keep the right knee out, now feel 10% in your front heel. And I used to make the mistake of not having that leg straight. Straighten it just by feeling your 10% in the heel. So by your weight going into the heel, let the leg be straight, but don't lock it out. I don't know if it's just a relief after guitar, but it's one of my favorites. Separate the feet, shoulder width, outside edges parallel, stretch up through the body. Feel the weight even in the feet, feel the stretch even through the body. And one to the right, bend from the middle, look towards the hands. Two, relax the upper body down over the right foot. Palms face the foot, fingers pointed towards each other. Three, reach straight forward. Upper body parallel to the floor, fingers stretch. Relax the upper body down over the left foot. You might feel a bit of that chest concave here too. And it's not huge, don't feel turtly. It's like, just don't puff the chest out. Five, roll to the left through a side bend into the gentle leaned back position. Knees bent, hips forward a little. Even bend throughout all the parts of the body. Don't crank the neck, don't strain. And six, roll out to the right. Feel the lower back release its pressure. And seven, back up to the top. Other way, one. And even the looking towards the hands is part of the stretch. It's a gentle look, but look. Two, relax down over the left foot. Try not to shift your hips. You'll feel more weight over it. You'll feel more weight in the foot with your body over it. Try not to shift the hips. Three, reach straight forward. And the legs are straight, but again, don't lock them. You might even imagine that you're just pushing into the floor with your feet and see how that engages through the body. Four, down over the right foot. Five, roll to the right, through the side bend, gently lean back. Push up through the chest. And six, roll out to the left. Again, feel the pressure released from the low back and come up safely from the side. Nice and easy. And just lower the arms. Very good. Number five, double dragon's leap from the sea. Go back to your shoulder width as a starting position. Turn your left toes out 45 degrees and step the right foot straight forward. Shift forward. The small lunge, push position. Good. And stretch. Keep that knee out. Help it out with your left hand. Use your right hand to aid your stretch by pulling. Form the circle with the arms under the body. Begin by shifting forward and back up to your push position. Good, exhale and go back. Inhale as you come up, but think again of breath and motion as part of the same process. Exhale, like they're just part of the same thing. I breathe out, I go back. I finish breathing, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Let's do a few fast ones. Not that fast. Inhale. Exhale. Try to stay relaxed. Try to stay aligned. Inhale. Exhale. One more fast one. Inhale. Release. Yes. Okay. Other side. Shoulder width apart. This is number five still. Double dragon's leap from the seat. Turn the right toes out. Step the left foot forward, shift forward, small lunge, push position. And stretch. And form the circle with the arms. Begin with your breath. Inhale. Shift forward back to your lunge. Try to come back to the same place you started. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale, breathe all the way in. Deep breath. Exhale, breathe all the way out. And a few fast ones again. Inhale. Number six, rhinoceros gazes at the moon. Separate the feet shoulder width apart. Round through the body, sink down again. Get that rounded, connected feeling in the legs and in the chest and arms. And make sure you do a little sit back and lean forward. It might feel like you're forward, but you're actually going to be upright. If you're sitting back and you lean forward, you'll actually be upright. Yeah. And to the right, bend forward. Bend forward, turn to the right, extend the right arm, and look up under the arm. Like before, try not to shift the hips. You will feel more weight over the right foot when your body's over. Try not to shift your hips. Turn back to center, right hand under left. Keep the legs bent, keep the rounded lower body. Bend forward, turn to your left. Extend the left arm. And look up under it, as if off into the distance. If you're holding your breath, start breathing deeply. Turn back, left under right. And one more to the right. Try to relax in the waist as much as you can. Which might sound hard when you're turning from there. Just see what you can release as waist tension. And back. Rock back upright, round the arms. One more to the left, bend forward a little. Turn. Turn back, rock upright, and you're released. Straighten the legs, lower the hands. Okay, number seven, ride the tiger. Hands on the hips, turn left 45 degrees. Try to keep the feet at that angle, even though you're stepping straight forward without going off in either direction. Sink a little, take small steps, straight forward. Try to have both knees bent the same amount so you're not lunged forward. Turn the shoulders and hold. Shift. Push off in small steps. Other way. Sink. Get a little bit of tuck. Start stepping up. Again, both knees bent the same. Turn the shoulders to the front. Shift. Push off.
Sorry, question.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I know you said so when you have both of your knees bent. I feel like this one's still coming in quite a bit when I twist.
Yes, ma'am.
But I can't really pull it out more.
That's a good
without
question.
Making my ankle hurt.
That's a very good question. Cool. I'll answer it as we step out into it. Okay, so this will be a little bit modified to answer the question, but it'll be good for everyone anyway. So sink down a little bit and step out just a little bit smaller than you're used to stepping out. It's okay, you can go smaller, it's all right. From there, bend the legs. Keep the knees out and turn the shoulders from there.
So is that out far enough?
Yes.
Okay.
At this time, that is out far enough. Yes.
Okay.
Yep, and push off. As long as it's not collapsing in a bad way, so like if you could see it So right here, like, I could do it out too far, right? But as long as it's not coming in like that.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
The idea is aligned.
Okay.
Yeah. So it'll feel out, but it's really aligned.
Okay.
That's a good question. Was that the left side? Should we even it out on the other side?
Yeah.
So, sink a little bit and set. Find your both knees out feeling like it's kind of like a big twisted embracing horse. Experience it on the other side. Yeah. Shift forward and push off. Good. Yes. Often we'll have a tightness in one side or the other that we don't even know we have until we start trying to do some symmetrical postures.
And I've sprained this ankle like several times, so
it's protecting this. Yeah.
Yes.
It's grown protective of itself. Yes, sir. You may find though that that pressure that you feel in the ankle eases over time as long as you don't push it too far in this posture. Yeah. Well, I wouldn't promise it, but we'll see. All right, number eight, Phoenix spreads wings. Are we on number eight? Yeah. Separate the feet, small to a middle distance. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's good, that's good, that's good. Yeah, sink a little, relax the arms. Circle back, up, forward. Breathe. Reverse. Just do it slowly today. And reduce. All right. Let's do number nine. Hit the tiger. Put the feet together. Turn the right toes out slightly. Sink down. Step out to the right and a little bit forward. Take the fist, spin the right leg, look left. Push off. And two, hit the tiger to the right. Right fist by the temple, look left. Push off. One more to the right. Hit the tiger. Do that on the other side as well. Feet together. Left toes out a little. Sink. Step. Left fist by the temple. Look right. Bend the left leg. Up. And two. And up. And last one. Hit the tiger, round it in the chest, arms. Left knee out enough to just be not collapsing it. And up. Okay. Whew. We're going over a couple minutes, so if you're on a tight schedule, you need to go, that's fine. But we're going over 2 minutes or so. Separate the feet, shoulder width, hands on the hips, posture 10, owl turns head, sink it down, round the knees out. The pelvis, tuck the chin, relax the shoulders. Slowly turn just the head to the right. Look a little farther with the eyes once you get to your natural limit without straining. And to the left. Right, slow. And to the left, slow.
back to center.
Release, straighten the legs, lower the hands. One more time, breathe in, circle the arms up. Breathe out, push palms down. All right, very good. Does it feel like it got hotter in here?
Maybe not.
Just checking if you got that internal heat feeling yet. It can happen. I drink a bunch of hot tea before class, so that happens. All right, let's bow up. We follow the five parts: faith, respect, perseverance, patience, and humility. Thank you, ma'am. Bow two, beginner students. Basic training dismissed.